It's been 3 years since the iPad mini got an upgrade, but we finally have one on our teardown table. And while the upgrades weren't big enough to make it into a video announcement from Apple, we still have a lot of questions. We know the mini got a system on chip upgrade to the A17 Pro, which is part of Apple's push to bring Apple intelligence to its entire line of devices. But I think what everyone wants to know is, did they fix the terrible jelly scrolling effect we saw on the mini 6? We got some answers, and they may surprise you. One theory as to why the Mini 6 jelly scrolled came down to the location of the display driver. We did a video on that, link in the description if you want to find out more. But basically, it came down to whether the driver board is attached vertically or horizontally to the LCD. Thanks to Lumafield's Neptune CT scanner, we can take a sneak peek inside the iPad Mini 7 to see if that display driver moved or not. And surprisingly, it doesn't seem to have. Everything else looks very similar to the Mini 6, except for that Apple logo. There's something funky going on there. Why does it have that thick outline? I need to break in to see what's going on here, but before I do, let's do a quick side-by-side comparison of the Mini 6 and Mini 7 screens. The results are a bit surprising. As reported by The Verge's David Pierce, the jelly scroll problem is still there, but according to our eyes and even our high frame rate cameras, the problem seems to have been reduced. How much you notice it may depend on how you use your device and how sensitive you are to the jelly scroll effect. You'll notice it more if you're scrolling through text, less so if watching videos. Improved jelly scrolling is interesting, but let's dig into this tablet and see if we can find any other surprises. I'm gonna use a heat mat to soften the glue under the screen, and together with Clampy's help, I have an entry point. The adhesive is pretty soft, and I'm having a pretty easy time making my way around. Just like last year's Mini 6, the bracket securing the display and digitizer press connectors also secures the battery press connector. With the panel assembly removed, I get my first look at the battery itself. To my surprise, not only is the press connector on the battery identical to the Mini 6, but the model number and capacity is also identical. Both are marked as model A25222 and are rated for 19.19 watt-hours. It's time to disconnect the battery press connector and play a game of stretch and release with these adhesive pull tabs. After 3 years of practice, I should be able to get at least a couple of these things out in one piece. That's one. And two. Three. Going for gold. Come on, number four. Ding, ding, ding. We have a wiener. But the house doesn't want to pay out. For some reason, there's still a bit of adhesive holding the battery. Reducing variation between models means more reusable parts, less complication, and less waste. Doubly so for the consumable battery, a component that needs to be replaced every few years. Here's a repairability boost for you. The USB-C port is easily accessible and replaceable. USB-C ports are high wear components, especially on devices like this that don't support wireless charging. And just like the battery, chances are good that it'll need to be replaced at some point. I'm gonna move over to the main camera, which should be under this bracket. So far, we've used the Phillips bit throughout, by the way. All the tri-point screws are on the outer edge. Some glued down coax cables, a speaker cable, a tiny press connector that looks very fragile, and more press connectors than you can shake a toothpick at. And finally, finally, I can pry up the logic board. After I remove a few more flex cables, glue down coax cables, and of course heat the entire case up because of course the logic board is glued directly to the case. Size 0 devices come with a hefty repairability price attached, folks. The logic board is pretty well shielded, both for heat dissipation purposes and to shield various chips from unwanted RF signals. The center shield is the only one that can be removed, all the others are soldered to the board. Right at the center of the board sits the A17 Pro system on chip. There's a layered sandwich of application processor and SDRAM module here. You can find our full chip ID over on iFixit.com. I'm gonna turn my attention to the LCD panel now to see if there's an upgrade to the display driver that might hint at how they quote unquote fixed the jelly scroll issue. To do that, I need to struggle through the size 0 flex cable so I can delid the board. Frustratingly, a side-by-side comparison of the iPad Mini 7 display driver with the Mini 6 display driver holds no clues. These displays appear to be using the exact same boards and chips. We're still working on our full chip ID, which you'll soon find on our website. Time to take a closer look at those camera modules. Both are glued in pretty securely, but they do come away with some gentle persuasion. One last wee nugget for this teardown. Remember the odd outline on the Apple logo in the CT scan? turns out the logo isn't etched into the metal like other Apple devices. If you're into collecting corporate symbols, here's your chance to get an Apple one. And I'll admit, I can't wait to see the case mods people are gonna make with this fruit-shaped opening. This is one of those rare teardowns that raises more questions than it answers. Despite popular expectation, the display driver orientation has not moved, and the chipsets have not changed. But still, through some trickery, Apple has managed to fix the worst of the jelly scrolling problems. On the hardware side, it's great to see that the battery connector, and USB-C ports are all very accessible, and the shared inventory of parts between the Mini 7 and Mini 6 is good news for the environment and DIY repair. But all of this sits behind the LCD screen, which is glued in place and difficult to remove without damaging. Combine that with the fact that Apple doesn't currently offer repair parts or manuals for this iPad mini, we're giving the iPad mini 7 a provisional score of 3 out of 10.